Hello, Tina McDermott here from Tina's Joyful Kitchen. And today I've got some healthy tips for you. Healthy snacks on the go. Healthy snacks on the go. And again, fast food in your refrigerator. As I love to have people have fast food in the refrigerator. So let's talk about what are some really quick, fun, easy, healthy snacks that you can grab and go. Grab and go. Here's my favorite, the crudité. Yes, I had to say a little French accent there, but not really. What I did, actually my niece did it for me. She got some Greek yogurt, plain Greek yogurt, put that on the bottom, and then we tossed in some Italian seasoning with a little bit of sea salt. A little bit of sea salt. I cut up some beautiful carrot strips and some celery sticks that are touching the bottom of the dip. It's a dip. And I'll smash these in and put a lid on it. And you can throw this in a bag and take that to work. Or just, if you're working from home, go right to the refrigerator and grab some fast food right there, some crudité. You can use whatever vegetables you like. Lovely, lovely, lovely snack on the go. Here's another fun snack that I most often have in my refrigerator. You can do yogurt. You can do Greek yogurt, plain yogurt. I always like plain yogurt. I don't like the flavored ones. And it's not that I don't like the taste. I don't like the added sugar that's in the flavored one. So if I'm going to add a sweetener, I will add my own monk fruit or stevia if I want sweetener. Otherwise, fruit is sweet enough. So you'll do half yogurt, half almond milk, or half regular milk, whatever you want to do. So it's half and half. Then you'll get some chia seeds. I always store my chia seeds in jars and in the refrigerator or the freezer. And I'll throw 2 to 3 tablespoons of chia seeds in with the yogurt and milk, and then get some frozen vegetables. I meant fruit, frozen fruit. And it's okay if it's fresh fruit or frozen fruit. Throw them in there, shake it up. You can shake it up. It's not gonna leak out, but just don't store this upside down. Shake it up, put it in the refrigerator for a couple of hours, best overnight, and you will have pudding. So now it's after lunch, it's after dinner, and you need just a couple of tablespoons of something yummy to eat. Make yourself some chia pudding. It's easy, it's fun, it's delicious. You can add cinnamon to it, you can add ginger to it, whatever you like. Remember, I'm the lazy inspirational chef, so whatever you're inspired, whatever your flavors are, I put frozen blueberries in this one. And I have some kiwis, I might add kiwis to it later at the top. And maybe even add some fresh walnuts, some chopped walnuts when you're going to eat it. I don't put the walnuts in right away, because they'll get a little mushy and I don't like that. So when I'm about to eat it, I'll get some toasted walnuts crushed up and I'll throw them right on the top. Talking about walnuts, what a lovely snack is having maybe an apple or an orange and a couple of walnuts, or perhaps an apple and an orange and some peanut butter. Now, a note about peanut butter. If you're going to do peanut butter, I think it's wonderful. I like to go organic. And you want to make sure in your ingredients, the ingredient says peanuts and salt. You don't want peanut butter that has the bad sugars in it, sugars in general, or the bad oils in it. You don't need any of the extra stuff. You just need peanuts and salt. And peanuts, as well, like the almond, like the walnuts, are your fat as well as your protein. Your fat and your protein. Every single meal should have a fruit or a vegetable and a fat and a protein. So you're going to get that if you have an apple or an orange and some peanut butter, or just go right over to almond butter. Again, ingredients, almonds, sea salt. I bought one once that was an organic brand. It was really good and it had sugar in it. We don't need the extra sugar, so try some almond butter. What about some almond butter or peanut butter on some dates? Ooh, yum. And if you've ever tried dates and peanut butter and carrots, they all go together beautifully. Some really fun snacks, put them in jars, put them in baggies, and away you go. Another good thing with the almond butter or the peanut butter are some rice crackers. There's no gluten in rice, so you can get yourself some nice rice crackers. Or another one of my favorite crackers, Mary's Gone crackers. Lots of different flavors with Mary's Gone crackers, and I like to get the original plain because then I can go sweet or savory. Like, you're not gonna want to put peanut butter on an everything cracker. you know, it just doesn't go well. So I just get the plain. But there's all sorts of different flavors. And you know how sometimes we just need that crunch? We need to crunch something. Mary's Gone Crackers really gives us that crunch. You could also go back to the crudité and eat your vegetables that have that wonderful crunch. Another excellent, excellent, excellent snack on the go are some sweet potatoes. These are Japanese sweet potatoes, and these are called Stokes purple sweet potatoes. Look how adorable they are. Scrub them really well. I don't peel them. I'm lazy. I don't have time for that. I scrub them, I wash them, and then bake them. Pull them out of the refrigerator, and now you can eat these delicious sweet potatoes. Yes, with almond butter. Yes, with peanut butter. Maybe a little yogurt on top of them. Maybe you just sprinkle a little cinnamon and salt on top of your baked sweet potato. Before you bake it, just make sure that you pierce some holes so that it doesn't explode in your oven. And no, I do not microwave them. Microwave just tends to deplete your fruits and vegetables of the active enzymes that help us digest, and enzymes equal life. So no, do not microwave them. Please put them in your oven, 350 degrees for about 30 minutes, but it depends on how big your sweet potato is. This one's going to take maybe about 20 minutes because it's really small. And I highly encourage you eating sweet potatoes. They're full of fiber, and they're delicious. And if you don't eat them now, start eating them. They're so good. What about a quick snack of some chicken broth? Make sure that it's organic, because the organic will not have MSG in it. And maybe a hard-boiled egg. Throw a hard-boiled egg in with some chicken stock and have some crudité with it. It's a really nice treat in the when it's cold outside to have some nice broth. It's very satisfying. What about some cashews? Have a couple handfuls or a handful of cashews along with maybe an apple or some celery sticks or carrot sticks. Cashews are wonderful. I always buy them raw and I toast them myself. And the same thing goes for my almonds or my walnuts. I buy them raw and I toast them myself. I literally put them right in the toaster oven, put it on toast, and it toasts them up. If you toast them, store them in the refrigerator though, because they'll go rancid really fast. Another one of my favorite little snacky snacks, I didn't make it, but I just kind of wanted to show it to you, is you're gonna get an avocado, open it up, smash it in your little bowl, sprinkle a little bit of lemon juice on top of it, a little bit of sea salt, and then get a hard-boiled egg and crumble your hard-boiled egg on top. What a delicious quick snack that is. Delicious quick snack that is. So there we have it, healthy snacks on the go. Thank you very much for being here. And until next time, namaste.